Harper Design and Harper Audio present Missions to Mars, a new era of rover and spacecraft discovery on the Red Planet by Larry Crumpler, read by Stephen Graybill. A note before we begin. To view maps, photos, and more, be sure to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider, or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/audio/missions-to-mars. It is good to renew one's wonder, said the philosopher. Space travel has again made children of us all. Ray Bradbury, The Martian Chronicles. Part 1. Knowing the Unknown. 1. Full Circle. The Kiowas reckoned their stature by the distance they could see. N. Scott Momaday, The Way to Rainy Mountain. Looking at Earth from Mars. The scene that lay before us looked like the rubble from a crumbled ancient city. We were standing out in the open on the surface in the frigid pre-dawn glow, looking east in the midst of a plain littered with dark, dust-coated angular rocks. We were surrounded by small craters, and the vista contained all the bleakness of an aftermath of some apocalyptic no man's land. Above the eastern horizon, pale in the pre-dawn haze, was a small blue-white star hanging silently in the sky. That small star was Earth, and we were seeing it from the surface of Mars. With that glance, we had come full circle. It was not a momentous occasion, judging from the casual interest we seemed to place on that observation, but there was an abiding sense that not only were we a long way from home, but we were also a long way from our humble beginning in our quest to know the Red Planet. We were finally on the surface of the red star that humans had observed for such a long time from the yonder blue-white star. As the day progressed, the sun ascended from the alien blue of the strange dawn, and those of us looking at this scene virtually through the eyes of the Spirit Rover continued our journey up the rocky slope, soldiering on to our next destination and another day's work on the red planet, Mars. The moment had passed, but it was the end of a beginning. But the moment was actually epic in its meaning. For thousands of years, Mars had been a red star in the sky. Only recently in the chronicle of human exploration, in fact within just the last few decades, have we been in a position to do better in our quest for understanding Mars than the simple tracking of the motions of the fiery star. Getting beyond this more primal association of the stars and mortal events, however, has been a difficult journey in the history of human interest in Mars. One of the more interesting ironies of the past decade of Mars exploration that illustrates how far we have come is that simple image taken early in the mission of Mars Exploration Rover Spirit. In the photo, we see the Martian pre-dawn sky looking east, and in this sky is a tiny star, Earth. It is a subtle yet dramatic image, accompanied in the press release image by an arrow and the words, "You are here." It shows our small place in the cosmic scheme, of course, but to me, it is an image evoking how things have changed in our view of the planets, and Mars in particular. Here we were, on Mars, looking at a bright bluish-white morning star that was another world. yet so far, so small in the sky that if you didn't already know all the teeming life and business of Earth, you could not tell much about the presence or absence of life on Earth from this tiny dot. Across the distance that it takes light to travel in 20 minutes between Earth and Mars, and 45 years earlier, I was one of those on that small blue-white morning star viewing Mars from afar. It was during the twilight of telescopic Mars observation in the beginning of the space age that I began setting up my small telescope in the backyard. And whenever Mars was in the evening sky, I attempted to look at it. I recall that on one particularly clear night, I could see what I suspected was one of the polar caps, but not much else. All those dark markings and such were the province of observers with larger and professional telescopes. Mars was always a somewhat frustrating object in this respect. One was aware that there would probably be a lot of interesting things to see if you could just find a way to see them. Now, after all those years and all that wondering what it was like on that planet, I was one of those on the other end of that gulf between two planets, not only looking back at Earth, but looking at the surface of Mars up close and personal. Seeing Red, Mars Mania, the Early Years. Maybe the interest in Mars is simply a consequence of popular culture, or who can say, maybe there is something else going on. There is the speculation among some people that life on Earth might easily have originated on Mars and was transferred here in the first few hundred million years of our planet's existence. That could explain the interest we humans have had in Mars. Our interest has been the vague desire buried in our DNA to see the homeworld again. For now, that is only unsatisfying speculation and does nothing to solve the riddle of life's ultimate origin. Yet the search for the answer to that question, that is, whether there was ever life on Mars or whether it is present even today, is one that we have been pursuing for many decades. It is one of many stories that we will come to examine. But for now, there is no single explanation backed up by evidence or careful social analysis regarding why Mars has been such a focus of attention through the centuries. Some of the attention on Mars from the beginning of recorded history, undoubtedly, reflected an interest traceable to the appeal that the color red has for most humans. Red sunsets, red deserts, red sports cars. You name it, and if it is red, it is probably visually more arresting for most people. Early cultures have had a fascination with Mars's perceived magical properties as a celestial object in its astrological role and in interactions with other celestial bodies, or its mythical origins and associations with war or other fiery events of mayhem that loom large in the human condition. And then there is a more modern obsession, born of Mars's rich history in fictional and imaginative depictions as an abode of interesting events, creatures, or societies. And finally, the fascination that the lay public may have favors Mars as a new destination that is colorful, far away, and a sort of new Southwest with all manner of exotic and richly colored scenery to be explored and seen by someone bold enough to do so. For a very long time, humanity has been in the position of looking at Mars from Earth as an oddly moving star, the fire star, as the early Chinese observers called it. This was the initial way we looked at planets, not by standing on their surfaces or peering at them through telescopes, but by looking at them as tiny dots of light in the night sky that moved unlike the steady stars. Probably in the time before recorded history, the red color of Mars was an obvious distinction because few objects in the night sky are so intensely ruddy to the unaided eye. The other thing that made Mars stand out to the eyes of ancient nighttime viewers was the fact that it was one of those special wandering stars, too. This penchant Mars had, in which it appeared to move backward from its normal motion for a period of time, referred to as retrograde motion, when combined with its unusual color, helped to create its special place in astrological lore of the night sky, as recorded by ancient Egyptian astronomers more than 4,000 years ago. The seemingly erratic changing of direction and the fiery appearance probably initiated thoughts of chaos, burning, and its destructive nature, inviting its association with the consequences of war. Beyond these mythical associations, early observers were concerned about making sense of the timing of the return of objects and periods of an object's visibility, rather than any interest in the objects themselves. The Chinese, for example, were interested in conjunctions of Mars, that is, the time when Mars goes behind the Sun, and kept a careful account of the motions of Mars even before the Zhou dynasty, more than 3,000 years ago, if not before. And they had good reason to be concerned because accurate calendars, which were in part built around observations of the celestial motions, were important as part of the authority of the ruling dynasties. And another important reason for an interest in keeping a very accurate tracking of the planets was the fact that, to them, Mars was associated with all sorts of bad events and war. Keeping track of Mars was just good business. The comings and goings of Mars in the night sky were important enough to early civilizations that the Mayans and Babylonians are known to have maintained a document of observations of Mars's movements. So while this interest can be traced back historically to the earliest known astronomical observations of the planet by the Chinese before 1000 BCE and many civilizations since then, Mars was little more than a point of light to the human eye, and there was simply no way to know anything about it as an object. Mars was a mythical placeholder for deities in the sky and the clockwork machinations of the fates, but not much else. The Trickster Planet, Coyote Mars. In my quest to understand how various groups had viewed Mars in the night sky over the years, I spoke with friend Joseph Aragon of the Acoma Pueblo in western New Mexico. I asked him what the Acomas called Mars. He told me that the traditional word for Mars meant simply crazy star, perhaps a reflection of its back and forth motion in the sky, or the retrograde motion that the geometry between Earth's and Mars's orbits appears to impart on the progress of Mars across the sky. Then I asked him about something else, a question that had emerged when I reflected on the twists and turns of the planet's exploration over all the years. As we will see, Mars has a habit of doing a kind of bait and switch on us as we learn new things. Just when we think we have grasped some new understanding, it often happens that the new knowledge is not the most important focus. Rather, there is something else that we are about to discover that is really the main point. When I mentioned this to Joe, I asked if Coyote, the eternal trickster so prominent in Native American legends, could in any way be similar to this penchant that Mars had for giving us little runarounds. He reflected for a minute and said that yes, it was probably entirely appropriate to think of Mars that way. After all, Coyote is also a wise figure, but mischievous. So I began to think of Mars as Coyote Mars, because there has always been this little bait and switch thing going on when we try to understand something. It is simply Coyote Mars doing what comes naturally. As Joe put it, Coyote, in his wisdom, was just making us all dig a little deeper to find the really meaningful thing behind something. In this case, the science of Mars. 2. Eyes on Mars. It is possible to believe that all the past is but the beginning of a beginning, and that all that is and has been is but the twilight of the dawn. H. G. Wells, The Discovery of the Future. a new world visible in the telescope. The focus on what might be called the astrological angle changed during the Enlightenment, also known as the Age of Reason, a time of evolving ideas that developed in the mid-1600s through the end of the 18th century. This was a period when there was a movement to a new philosophy that advocated that observations and reasons could serve as the main methods of understanding the world rather than beliefs and portents. New and more powerful ways of observing were coming into existence. One of these was the telescope, and that naturally and very quickly was turned to the heavens. This was also a period when the Copernican Revolution had taken hold and Earth was demoted from its centrality in the universe and became just one of the many bodies circling the sun. The idea that Earth was like the other planets and heavenly bodies no doubt inspired the foundation of ideas prevalent at the beginning of the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.